by.
This is the 916. These are my people.
The Kings are back in Sacramento.
I can't wait to get back there. We have an opportunity to go home and win a game.
The city showing up for its team.
We need everyone behind us in Sacramento, which I feel we definitely have.
Fox, Red Velvet, Monk, everybody.
In an even series.
We have to be the more aggressive team.
Tonight, live reports with all the action from the Golden One Center. The mini players watching their heroes live out their dreams.
Davion Mitchell. I can like shoot in threes.
And why there's one more beam to light at night.
We jokingly call it the Janky Beam.
In a KCRA 3 News special, King's Quest Playoff Pride.
Well, good evening. Lisa Gonzalez, Del Rogers. Welcome to the King's Quest Playoff Pride half-hour special. Tip-off is about 30 minutes away.
Yes.
Fans are still being let into the Golden One Center for tonight's Game 5. And a good thing about this, Lisa, is that both teams have held service, meaning both teams have won all games played in their respective arena. If that trend goes on, the Kings will win in 7 because it's a 7-game series.
There you go.
2 here, 2 in San Francisco, 1 back here, 1 in San Francisco, 1 here. It's a 7-game series, best of 7. It's tied at 2 each now. So on paper, the Kings should win tonight, Lisa.
I like that, Matt. That's Delonomics, and I like it.
There you go.
I'm voting for that. I mean, you're right. They've each done what they're supposed to do at home.
Right.
And the teams being so close to each other, just 90 miles apart, it's been pretty interesting to see. We've only seen about 10% Warrior fans, 5 to 10% Warrior fans here tonight. But fans are already inside, a lot of them still trickling in, a lot of them really excited for tonight. Of course, there's been an over concern about star De'Aaron Fox because of his broken left index finger. Of course, that's his shooting hand. Right. And we do know, though, we learned about an hour and 15 minutes ago that he will be starting tonight. So that was the big question all day. But we still don't know how effective will he really be. We saw him shooting at practice earlier today. He was taking some threes from the corner, making a lot of them. Didn't make all of them, but he was doing pretty well. He's got that little finger cast on. So he, you know, had some coaches with him. He's getting used to that little finger brace that he's wearing. I'm more concerned, actually, about someone hitting it, like a Draymond Green or somebody like that hitting it in the game.
Or if he goes for a rebound or a bad pass, you know, just a natural movement and the ball catches it. Or someone slaps at the ball and catches his finger.
Yeah.
You know, so I think him starting is great. And if he doesn't go the full game, Davion Mitchell will be there to spell him a little earlier than he usually does.
Yes.
Now for more, let's go inside of the Golden One Center where tonight's Game 5 will be tipping off at 7 o'clock to check in with KCRA3's Michelle Davenport. Michelle?
Yeah, Del, Lisa, the best thing about this series now, it's a best of 7 series, but now it shifts to a best of 3 series, and the Sacramento Kings know they must protect home court and take a 3-2 lead before heading back to the Chase Center.
Huge game, obviously, especially being at home. You always want these games in front of a home crowd.
Everybody's locked in mentally, you know. Played closer to 48 minutes than we have all year, you know, on the defensive end, you know, and that showed. That's how we got those first 2 weeks. So we got to keep putting that together.
We're in a battle right now. Obviously, we both teams take care of home court.
We've been playing good defense, but I feel like there's moments we can play better.
Each team is adjusting as the series goes on, adding new plays, taking away plays, defensively trying to switch things up, using different lineups. So the series just kind of continuously has life.
We just got to put a whole game together, all the little pieces that matter, you know, and we can do that. It's going to be good now.
So, of course, the Sacramento Kings must protect home court tonight and, again, take that 3-2 lead in this series. Looking around the crowd, this is Game 5. Compared to Game 1 and 2 inside here, there's a lot more Warriors fans and, of course, those previous 2 games for the Sacramento Kings. Guys, tip-off's later for 7 p.m., but, hey, the excitement is building inside here, of course, inside the Golden One Center. Back your way outside.
Good stuff, Michelle. And let me give you some advice. You got to get some of them earplugs, the orange ones. that they use out in construction sites? Because it's going to be loud.
Well, you can hear it. They're starting right now with the Sacramento chants behind us right now. They're not even inside. We're seeing, look at that, Dell. There's another line forming, and they got pretty clear, but we got another little traffic jam getting into the G1C right now. The sixth man is ready to go, and KCRA3's Melly Wingo is already inside the G1C with more on the fans and how excited they are, Melanie.
It is so exciting here inside Golden One Center. We're in the concourse area, and basically the doors to G1C empty right in here. Anyone who comes in the building walks right by where we are, and they are so excited. We're seeing people with the old school jerseys on and the new ones. So much purple, so many cowbells. We have signs, they have necklaces, they have all kinds of paraphernalia that represents the Sacramento Kings and their pride for the Kings. So many people talking today about how this team has excited them. They've been fans for years and years, and they're not just excited about the team, but they're excited about what the team has done to Sacramento, united this city in such a way that everyone has gotten behind the Kings this season, and it's just a joy for folks to see. So tonight, we're taking a look at a massive crowd, as Michelle Dapper just talked about. We're seeing people with their purple, as I say, their lights, their rumble sticks. So many fans out here tonight getting pumped up about this game. A lot of optimism as well. You know, there's nothing that matches the energy of the home court advantage for the Kings. And that's what people are really relying on tonight and saying that's going to help the Kings. Also, what's going to help the Kings is this electric crowd, this very supportive crowd. That's exactly what they're doing tonight. They got their bells. We got the fans. Coming up in a few minutes, we're going to talk to some fans about why they're wearing the jerseys they're wearing. That's coming up at 6:45. Back to you.
Yes, it is the Cowbell Kingdom for a reason. The best fans in the whole NBA, and they've had that record for decades. But of course, Dell, there are some new fans.
Yes.
I'm not even talking about the bandwagon fans.
You're
they're
right.
Just a new generation.
I think their family members have started them while they were young because they know the success the Kings are going to have down the future, they hope. With more on young fans, let's turn things over to KCRA3's Jason Marks.
Make sure we change directions on that.
Every day at the Youth Basketball Academy in Rockland.
Stay balanced, you guys. Stay balanced. Stay
youngsters balanced. Shoot for the future.
I love how it feels when the shot goes in.
I've been playing it for a while.
Are you any good?
Yes, I'm good.
As you see, these kids don't lack any confidence in their play. They also don't lack any confidence in which team they hope to someday play for.
If I hear the Kings are playing, I turn it on as soon as it starts.
They are my hometown team. And I like to root for my hometown teams.
Kings fans are very passionate, and I think they have the best fan base in the NBA.
Most of these players are only 10 and 11.
Jump shot, knock it down. Boom.
Meaning they've never seen the Kings in the playoffs, and they're well aware of it.
It was long ago when they were good, and not in my lifetimes. And it's really cool.
I'm not used to it because every single time it comes around this time, I'm not used to watching them. And they're finally in it.
People have said that they're like not good. People have said that they play horrible defense. I'm like, no, they don't. They're actually a good team.
Pretty exciting, especially since it's been 16, 17 years. It's amazing.
But this year's Kings are different.
We're gonna knock it down.
Giving young fans a reason to watch.
I like Sabonis and Fox because they are great players and they're great all-stars too.
Davion Mitchell. He's their main three-point shooter. And I like him like shooting threes.
Jump shot.
And just like so many Kings fans.
Dribble.
They too hope this playoff run only ends with a championship.
Amazing. Like, I can't even think of a word. That'd be great.
I hope they get it that far without going home.
It would mean a whole lot to this city and for my family too, because we love the Kings.
For photojournalist Jack Noonan.
Good job. I like that.
Jason Marks, KCRA3 News.
Well, Jason Marks said that those young fans said they're going to be in front of the TV, rooting on the Kings. Hopefully they can win game 5 tonight over the Warriors.
Just got to tell those young fans, it's not an easy life being a lifelong Kings fan.
Well,
I've got wrinkles from it. I'm telling you, who knows how many years off my life it's taken. But welcome to the family.
There you go.
All right, coming up, Kings fans hoping to light the beam at the Golden 1 Center tonight, but it won't be the only one if the Kings get the win. The story behind this beam at a Broadway brewery. Counting down until tip-off of Game 5, getting closer and closer. And, you know, everyone's got their favorite player. I've said this since the beginning of last season. Davion Mitchell, when he came to Sacramento, I saw him play.
Why?
I was like, that's my favorite player because he can play defense.
Okay.
He can play defense.
Stuff.
And that's not easy to do.
You're right.
That's not easy to do. So, you know, that's why he's been my favorite player. Before that, it was Jason Williams.
My favorite player is Harrison Barnes.
Yeah. Why is
calm,
that?
Calm, cool, collective, and he's a champion. He's already won a ring, and he can help other players learn how to win a ring. That's why.
The Black Falcon helps him rise up.
There you go. And for more with the exciting fans, let's turn things out to Melanie Wingo, who is outside of the Golden 1 Center. Melanie.
Yeah, we were outside all afternoon talking with fans about their favorite players. I thought you guys were going to ask me who my favorite player was, and I was going to give you the very diplomatic answer of they're all my favorite because they're doing so well this season. But take a look. Look at this crowd. All of these fans are so excited to be here. They are all wearing their Kings outerwear, and many folks, just like these two dudes right here, they're wearing their jerseys. I got Sabonis and an old school Weber one over on this side of things. We see a lot of Fox jerseys tonight. So we wanted to know why different fans chose different players to represent on their jerseys. Here's what some of them told us.
I got on a Jason Williams white jersey, just old school today, so yeah.
And how about you?
I'm wearing a Fox jersey.
Okay, there you go. So you got Fox on the back of your jersey there.
Go back.
I got Fox. Wearing
got Fox
tonight.
Representing for
yep.
Fox.
Oh, yeah.
So we got Fox and Weber. Who do you think is the better player, Fox or Weber?
Oh, I would have to say they're equally good, but being Fox is current, I would have to give it to Fox right now.
Okay, so some people are remembering their favorite Kings players, but then going with the current Kings players to wear on their backs. And you guys, can you hear how loud it is right now? I almost can't hear myself think, but what I can tell you is the fans here tonight are absolutely stoked about Game 5, the Kings versus the Warriors. I bet you can probably figure out who these folks want to win tonight. Go Kings, like the beam. That's what they're all telling me. Lee Sindel, I'm going to send it back to you because it's so loud in here, I can't even hear myself think.
I wish I could see Melanie Wingo. We can only hear her.
We can only hear her.
I bet she's just in a whole, like a mosh pit. Everybody with her. You know, there's been creative ways businesses have been using to celebrate the light the beam theme with food and drinks and apparel. A lot of things going on in Sacramento region.
They're putting the beam on everything. Blankets, candles, coffee beans. But there's one brewery in Sacramento that has found a way to keep Broadway bright. KCRA3's Jason Marks reports.
Breweries tend to be part of the fabric of any community. New Helvetia on Broadway is no different.
What can I get you?
New Helvetia is the name of the land grant that established Sacramento.
The brewery opened its doors 10 years ago and has established itself as a Midtown area symbol.
A place where people can gather and have a beer among friends and neighbors.
And as you can imagine, right now, bar talk revolves around basketball.
For a city like Sacramento to have something to root for and to rally behind the Kings, I think that's you can't ask for anything more.
It's really fun to see it all start to come together after all the, you know, all those years of not having any success.
And as a symbol of the community, New Helvetia wanted to create a symbol of its own.
And we had talked about doing something with this this light?
I was actually out of town. I called my coworker Daniel and asked him if he could put this thing up.
I just looked at the building and I'm like, what could I do with this?
I didn't know what to expect.
We had this this LED light strip that we procured from Home Depot. We had this old sign stanchion here and went on the roof, dropped it down, secured it to the stanchion, and and it was easy peasy.
And we had it up in time for the game on Saturday.
Later that night, the Kings won game two, and there was one more beam brightly shining.
Honestly, I didn't think there was gonna be that much fanfare about it, and I felt like a proud papa. Like, when I saw everybody cheering, I was like, wow, I did that.
Light the beam!
We jokingly call it the Janky beam because it's clearly not the real beam.
Janky or not, this one has just as much meaning.
It was a fun way to celebrate the city and the Kings.
The hope is that this beam will be lit a lot over the next few weeks and for a long time to come.
This was already here. It's already sticking up. We don't have a sign, so this might be New Helvetia's new calling. When we have a new beer, we might just click that on and everybody can know to come. You know, enjoy some tasty beer.
For photojournalist Jack Noonan, Jason Marks, KCRA 3 News.
And New Helvetia is holding a watch party tonight. And of course, they hope the Kings win so they can light their beam. It's like the gathering signal.
Yeah.
Come gather around the beam. Have exactly, some New Helvetia
exactly
beer.
Right. Exactly right. Well, you know, game five, we're about 11 minutes away from game five. Series tied at 2 games each. When we come back, we'll hear from Coach Mike Brown as to what the team needs to do to win game five.
Looking live inside the Golden 1 Center, where we are just minutes away from tip-off between the Sacramento Kings and the defending NBA champs, the Golden State Warriors. The series tied at 2-2. Sacramento Kings hoping to light the beam and make it 3-2 and take home their first playoff win in more than 16 seasons.
Yes, it's been a long time since the Sacramento Kings won a playoff game, Lisa, but I think tonight everything is okay. Even though De'Aaron Fox, you know, busted his finger, he's still going to play, and they're playing at home where the Kings have won every home game throughout these playoffs. I know it's trivial, but it's very important.
It is very important.
And for more on what head coach Mike Brown expects from his team so they can win game five, let's turn things to Michelle Dapper, who is inside of the loud Golden 1 Center. Michelle, can you hear me?
Barely, Dell. Of course, Scott Moak is getting this crowd fired up right now. But again, it is a pivotal game five. And if anyone knows about us sports people, we love numbers. We love percentages. We love odds. We love statistics. But both coaches say throw all of that out the window. They're not focusing on any of that. It's focusing on fundamentals tonight in game five.
I mean, you know, every game is important, and we always try to put extra importance on different games based on circumstance. And honestly, none of that matters to us. You know, what it matters to the narrative, to the broadcast. You can throw on all the stats, and whoever wins game five wins whatever percentage of the time, and none of that matters to us. What matters to us is taking care of the ball and rebounding, as we didn't do that the first two games of the series here in this building. And if we do that, we like our chances, and that's what we're focused on.
No, I mean, it sends a big message. You know, you want your guys to have not just a physical toughness, but a mental toughness. And it's great if it starts from your leadership and trickles down. And, you know, people forget that Keegan got banged up and continued to play too. And I'm sure he probably looked at Domas back then, that, you know, and some of the other guys that might have been hurt at certain times and said, no, tape it up. I'm going to continue to go. You need that, because at this time of the year, maybe not to that extent, but this time of the year, everybody's banged up. And the further along you go in the playoffs, that's some more guys that you'll have that are a little bit beat up.
a pretty cool moment here inside the Golden 1 Center just moments ago as they awarded De'Aaron Fox the Clutch Player of the Year trophy, giving Monty McNair some hugs. Vivek was there, of course, exchanging hugs. So again, our very own De'Aaron Fox, the NBA's Clutch Player of the Year. And I tell you, it's starting to get pretty loud in here, guys. And I do know the Warriors fans' strategy. They decided to wear yellow shirts, so you can really tell, of course, the fan base apart tonight. But yeah, a little bit more Warriors fans than, of course, the previous two games, but this is predominantly a Sacramento Kings crowd. Lisa Dell.
That's some good inside stuff, Michelle. We'll talk to you a little bit later tonight at 10 and 11 o'clock when you give us the post game from the Kings locker room. I'm going to make a prediction here. If it's a close game, I think the Kings win. Their fans are going to get them through. If it's a blowout game, I think the Warriors win.
How do you think Fox is going to do?
You know, I'm worried. And I know you put me on the spot, but I'm being honest. I'm really worried that if someone dings that finger, he catches a bad pass, or someone slaps at the ball, and then he's done. I think he's done.
And you know they may be targeting it, too.
Right,
the Warriors may be going after that.
So I think Davion Mitchell will fill the void.
He'll be ready. He'll be ready to go. And he plays great defense against Steph especially. Well, the king of all of the Kings, the all-time favorite, Slamson, is going to be very busy tonight getting the fans riled up. But he was there with some kids earlier today at Kaiser Roseville, visiting children in their pediatric center, putting smiles on their faces because they can't make it down to the game today. Hopefully they'll get to watch it tonight from the hospital, but always good when Slamson goes out there and does that. He was skiing at Sugar Bowl over the weekend, too. He's very, very, very busy Lion. And, you know, a lot of Kings fans are beaming with pride, and we appreciate all of you have shared your photos with us and videos of you lighting your own beam and your King pride, wearing your Kings jerseys and your shirts. We would love to see all of your photos. Just scan the QR code that you see on the bottom of your screen, and we would love to see that hashtag playoff pride. We will show them here on KCRA3 and online as well.
Thanks for watching. Go Kings, light the beam.